So the first one I wanted to run past you, it's a little bit gone past now, but it was something that happened about a week and a half ago. It was the Houseparty scam. This got sent to me typically at this time via WhatsApp. All right, got forwarded to me, people saying Houseparty, if you sign up to Houseparty, you're going to get scammed. Your account's going to get hacked and money's going to be taken from your bank account and charged for who knows what. Have you heard about this?
Yes, a lot.
A lot, exactly. And I think I'm fair in saying that this sort of thing happens pretty much every time an app comes out. Every time there's something new and trending, there's someone out there who wants to disrupt or just troll and puts this stuff out there. And I can imagine, you know, I remember this happening with TikTok, with Facebook way back when that first came out. It's the same sort of
thing. Any channel. Like you say, any channel, like there's going to be, someone's going to, there's a hacking scandal. And I think one of the first problems is people's definition of hacking, when most times it's because you've got a really crappy password. But yeah, there's a carry on. I've got my opinion.
You got your good. And that's what we're looking for, really. And so they said, I mean, their first response was, all right, we're sticking up $1 million to find out, effectively $1 million bounty to find out. We want proof of this. You know, tell us where this is happening. We'd like to fix this as soon as possible if this is true. Putting $1 million on the line, that's a huge stake. And that's what led me down the thought train of who are the people behind this app who are able to just stake $1 million on something.
By saying that you're willing to pay $1 million for somebody to prove that this is true means that you're backing your own product. You're like, there is no way. And whoever's doing this smear campaign, we'll pay $1 million if we can, and they'll probably take them to court or whatever it is. And 9 times out of 10, you're going to find it's the amount of scams and fake news that's going on everything, not just Houseparty. But if you find somebody's made up something and then it's spread like wildfire, it's happened to Zoom. We saw the news with Zoom, maybe some more legitimate things behind Zoom, but it's just another one of those scaremongering things. And it's exactly what you just said. In the past, like anytime new tech comes out, anytime news, I mean, I remember hearing about Houseparty probably a few months ago, a year ago when it first came out, and now it's suddenly made this comeback. Right now there's a war of video conferencing tools.
Yeah.
Because that's what we're all doing. My wife uses Houseparty with her friends, no problems there. And the whole hacking thing is, like I was making the joke earlier, is one, it's crappy passwords. Two, you've probably signed up somewhere else and there's some other app that's playing a part. I don't really think there is. I mean, yes, there probably is on the dark web and all that, but like something as big and as mainstream as this is going to have malicious intent, in the sense that, yes, we get data for advertising. Yes, we look at what you do. But building an app that now allows people to go in and get your online banking details. Yeah. I mean, your banking cannot be that secure if an app is getting into it. I mean, if you look at the security alone on banks.
Yeah. But I love the idea that it's within reason. The reason it gets forwarded, this message, this screenshot, because it's plausible enough to people to go, yeah, I have that thing. Should I be worried? And then people start to perpetuate that lie, effectively, because there's no other way around it. It's something that's fabricated, which is why the makers of a Houseparty put up such a big stake, because they just knew there's one really quick way to like say, hey, we believe so much in our product.
Yep.
We know that's not the case, that people are hacking, that we're prepared to, if someone can give us an answer, we'll give you $1 million. You can have it. Like,
do you know what I think is what one of the trends I've noticed? And I don't know if I'll be pissing off some of your listeners or as touch, but most of these people who spread the hacking rumors around apps or spread the scaremongering are the same people that you'll look on their Facebook feed and they've got like, what kind of a cat are you? What kind of a donut are you? They're the same people, because they sign up with their Facebook profiles into these dodgy apps, which is what happened with Cambridge Analytica and all that stuff.
Yeah.
It's the same people. People like you, myself, probably some of your listeners, tech savvy people, not that tech savvy, are smart. They know that this, I'm not going to sign up for it. And I can guarantee that if you go and look at the stats of the people who are believing this, who are forwarding the messages, it's the same. I've got older family members that will send me these, forward this mail for good luck and all this chain. They're the same
people. Chain emails.
Yep. And they are probably, if I can recall, are the ones who forwarded me the message. Stay off Zoom. It hacks into your system. And I'm like, yeah, I've been using Zoom a while now. I'm okay.
Yeah, we're both home remote workers anyway, so this is no different from us. So, yeah, but this is obviously a growth period for something like Houseparty. You're right in saying Houseparty was around before the pandemic and before the isolation. It's just that it's been adopted by people because it's a great way to stay in touch, play games, etc. So this is their real growth moment. They're probably thinking, this is great. But suddenly they get this harmful piece of information that hasn't come from a competitor. It's come from someone just sat there going, that'll be funny. I'll send it to my friends.
It's interesting. Again, it's these small things. I mean, especially the time that we're living in right now, the tiniest seed gets planted and it just grows and goes mental.
I think I even saw, this is slightly off topic from where we are, but WhatsApp were talking about introducing, and this is something I think this week, WhatsApp, obviously Facebook owned, Facebook, huge misinformation drive. Facebook were pushing forward this idea that they wouldn't allow people to keep forwarding misinformation.
Yeah, I saw that.
So I mean, that's obviously a really great, just suddenly controlling something that way is usually frowned upon, you know, by consumers. They're saying, hang on, you want to control what I like, how I communicate? That's a no-no. That's going to drive some people away. But if you're controlling something that has such a huge impact, especially this is around the COVID stuff, it's always going to be necessary for businesses like this to take. I mean, I've seen it in the press called draconian measures, but actually they're not draconian. They're just necessary measures to stop the spread of bad information through digital communications.
I welcome it. I honestly, the amount of, I know there's people who sit there and they forward it to all their WhatsApp groups or their Facebook messengers. And it, I mean, it's absolute drivel and rubbish that they send. But I do think that in a sense, they're probably not going to put it on every topic. There's going to be algorithms in place, like especially with COVID, you know, they're going to be like, okay, this, I mean, I've seen some well dodgy stuff, but if they're going to have filters in place like this type of content, no. Because you're going to find there are the people like exactly going back to Houseparty that somebody's forwarded to six of their WhatsApp groups or whatever friends they've got. And I think it's a good call. There's going to be upset people, obviously, but it's probably the very people that spam everyone.
Yeah.
I agree with it in a sense. I think it would also be, it's a good tool for fake news. It'll be interesting if something like this rolled out into Twitter and you could only retweet so many times or at so many times, or I don't know, you know,
that would
I
mean? That would break their model though, surely. That would just be,
yeah, I'd be heartbroken.
I mean, yeah, where would we be without the numerous WhatsApp groups full of memes? I mean, that's,
yeah, I mean, life. I've got select content that I will forward, like obviously there's my mates and there's some really stuff that I would not probably forward to my mom and dad's group. But you choose who you go to. But I think if you've got one asset, one duplicate that you are just forwarding out to everyone, it's a trend. There's something going on. You're spreading a message that must be important. Because if you're spreading that to everybody you know,
yeah,
broadcasting it, then there must be something behind this. And I think they're being quite clever there. I think this is just the beginning. Then they'll start tweaking it and working out like only these topics or only non-salacious images, or I don't know.
Yeah,
it's just I'm just assuming now.
If you're thinking about the world of mass emails that used to happen, they still happen, but they obviously everyone has spam filters now. They're built into Gmail and these things. You don't see half the spam you used to back in the day when you used to have Yahoo as your main email address and internet provider. But maybe that's the way it's going with WhatsApp. Actually, it may be a bit more manual and it's on your phone. I don't know. You can definitely get WhatsApp for your PC or Mac. But actually, if you wanted to broadcast to mass markets, that'd be the way I'd do it. If I had to send something to loads of people.
They're probably going to put that in with WhatsApp for Business. So I started using that actually about 2 weeks ago. It's quite a cool communication tool. Like, it's quite frictionless if people want to get in touch with you. But it's, I think they're going to be careful. And it might be something, and again, this is all guessing and things like that, but if you can imagine like groups on Facebook, at one point you got them, you could talk to your group and everything, then they put an algorithm in place and now you can't talk to all your group. It depends what you talk about. And that's going to happen on there. You're going to have like maybe 500 people in your WhatsApp Business group or something like that, and it's only going to go to 100 people. So they'll put an algorithm in there as well. There'll be filters.
That's a good marketing. It's segmentation, right?
Yeah. I don't think they could do it to personal WhatsApp, because that's where it starts kicking off. Like, hey, this is my freedom of speech. I can talk about what I want.
So we've gone from this 1 million bounty, which is effectively to deter misinformation, moving into mass communication. I think that's a really interesting topic anyway for maybe another day. We'll part that for a little bit.
Be interesting to follow.